Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to another video of Journal with Tanushk. If you're new here, consider subscribing to my channel and also ring the notification bell so that you can stay notified as to whenever I'm posting a new video. Getting into the video, well today I'm here with a video in which I'm just going to be showing all my paintings from May 2020 to September 2020. So this was like my first ever acrylic painting. That was an original, to be specific. The second one that it's upcoming, this one, and this one is the second acrylic painting that I made. I really like it because the colors are really vibrant in this. The texture could be a lot much better, but as I'm not really professional at acrylics, I really wasn't able to make it properly. And the third one is this beautiful, my most favorite acrylic painting, and this was what I made on 20th June 2020, which was after like my first and second acrylic painting. I realized I improved a lot, and if you really would like to watch a video on how I made this, then make sure to leave a comment down below requesting any painting you guys would like to see me make in my any other upcoming watercolor with me videos. And that was it, like for all my acrylic paintings. Now this is a sketchbook that I own, and this is more likely to be like a drawing book, not meant for watercolors, but I yet tried it. The first page was really my favorite. This is also like a really favorite painting of mine. It says the Koi Pond, and I really like it. Next is the Bon Appetit, and you all know that it is the French word for like eating, like beginning, like good meal kind of thing, and I really like it. I like the colors. I actually painted this in one of my videos, but I really like this one more because it's more specific, and I made this on 23rd June. I really like this as a painting. I think I could yet be better in the illustration of the donut, but yet I really like it. This was actually made the subsequent day with the excitement. And then here is the next and my most favorite acrylic paintings of all, I mean watercolor paintings of mine. This was painted on 28th June, and that was like 5 days later because I got busy with the school thing. I really like all the kind of detailed illustrations I made of every vegetable, and also cheese and olives, and everything looked really good in that pizza painting. This painting is actually, I was testing out a new set of watercolors that I brought, and turns out they were really good. It was actually the Domes one, the Domes watercolor set. If anyone has watched my video of my entire stationery collection, they might know it. And I really like it. I liked it. I did not use it after that, but yet I really like them. Here is the real traditional set of watercolor. This was where I actually began my real like watercolor paintings. This was my first ever watercolor painting, as you can tell by the details, because it's not that good as to what I make in today's day. The second watercolor painting that I made subsequently after this was not what I expected. Like, you can't anyway say that this was like my second watercolor painting with the real watercolor supplies, like what you would ever use, like the real watercolor paper, stuff like that. So this was not what I was expecting for my second watercolor painting, but really I was so happy when it turned out to be so beautiful. And that was it. I really liked both of them. It was like a negative painting tutorial that is on YouTube, and I tried it with a little bit of my own twists with the colors and the leaf size. This one is actually a better version, to be honest, of another similar painting that I made on YouTube, which was actually the same kind of painting, but yet the right hand one was made before this one. Actually, I like the first one more because there are less hot air balloons. And also I think the watercolor splashes look really good in this one rather than the other one. And that was it for both of them. This was like, this one is the one painting which you know I made on YouTube, a complete separate video. Indeed, this was my painting, first painting for my watercolor with me episode 1, and that was it for it. This is my behind the scenes watercolor painting. If you guys, I mean, this one was actually inspired from this painting, and if you guys would like to see me just making this painting for my part 2 video, then make sure to comment down like I said already. And I really like this painting as well. Now this is what you guys already know. Not properly, but yes, you guys know it. It was actually in my video in which I tell how to blend watercolors like a pro. And then the other one, I didn't want to waste these, so I just made these illustrations on them and they turned out really nice. Like, I didn't like the Eiffel Tower one more, but yet, they both were nice. And that was it for both of those polaroid structures. And this was actually a watercolor painting, which was inspired from an animated video version of a song, which said, I think it was, I'll cry about it later, and I really like the scene of it. So I just painted it. It was really good. It was more likely to be like an animated version of what you would make with watercolors. So I really like this painting in my collection as well. This is actually a facial portrait painting. Do not judge me. This is my first time I made a facial portrait using watercolors, and I know the eye is way too big. The details are not that good. The face structure is good. I actually was having high expectations, but yet, what can you expect from a completely noob watercolor artist? So, I wasn't able to make that properly, but yet, I will try further later on, someday, and I'll make a better version of it. And that was it for all my typical watercolor paintings. Now we head on to the doodle section. This is a YouTube doodle. This is also a behind the scenes painting. And I really like it. This is the second version, but this is a better version of this. This was what I made on YouTube, and this was actually inspired from the behind this one. And yet, I really like this more than this because this has more detail in it. I just don't know. I really like this one more. The colors are really bright. Maybe I made it with a lot more dedication. This one was the quarantine video. I mean, looking back at those videos, it's so funny with the quality of the video. So here's it. Here's what it really looks like. That video wasn't able to really tell what the colors were, because that time the quality of my videos was not that good. But now, I mean, you can clearly see this is actually a video I made on my channel of quarantine doodle ideas. And it's not that famous of a video, but I really like it yet, especially the house thing. This was actually, you know this, almost anybody knows it in today's day. This is like a relaxing therapy you can do to just, you know, it's really relaxing time just making this kind of doodles page. This is the Facebook doodle. This is actually another video on my YouTube channel. And this was like, I tried doodle. The video name was Doodle With Me. I'll leave a link of all of these videos in the description below so that you guys, anyone who is eager to just see all of these videos, can see them. This is the first video on YouTube of my channel. There I started speaking, so this video really means a lot to me. As well as, I really like how the eyeball turned out. This is another separate video on my channel. As I said, I'll leave a link in the description box below. Now this is Times Square illustration again. I think it's, I don't know, it's a sketch with fine liners. I really like it. This one was actually like half black and white and then half colored, but then I lost my interest in completing this piece, so I don't like it that much. This is another video on my YouTube channel. This is also a part of another video on my YouTube channel. This was, I don't remember the video name, I'm so sorry about that, but it was again something related to quarantine. This was the second page, like one of my most favorite pages that I've ever made till now. Indeed, I'm even thinking of making a bullet journal theme on that one. So, here is one of my most favorite things. I think I keep on saying one of my favorite paintings and illustrations all the time, so I'll leave it up to you guys to judge my paintings. This is like another, if I don't say favorite, then what will I ever say? So this is midway through because this is halfway I made my art journal. first ever watercolor painting, and this is actually the inspiration for the plant painting I made on my YouTube channel. This is a plant in real life that I own. The second one is the yellow one. These both were made subsequently, or like one day and the other one on the other day. Rarely like them a lot because they are my first ever watercolor paintings, considering how good it turned out. So I think these both will always be like my most favorite watercolor illustrations. This is another video on my YouTube channel, which was calligraphy. I think it was hand lettering and doodle with me. I like it, not a lot, but I like it. This is a curtains illustration. This is a beautiful curtain illustration I found on Pinterest, and also it's a curtain that really matches my house curtains. It's actually inspired from my house curtains themselves, but yeah, obviously I really wanted some changes. I didn't want it to look too similar, so I made all of these differences in it a little. This is a watercolor set illustration, and then a diamond in a black kind of circle illustration. I really like both of them. Not both of them. I don't like the watercolor set painting. This is another hobby or an addiction I got for once, in which I started just making splashes of all of this. This is my favorite songs illustration, which is like a very tiger kind of a background, and I really like this. This is actually a fun one. This was like live a balanced life, and then I made this cup, and then all of these things balanced all at once. These are like the final last illustrations I'm showing you guys. They're set pure, so I made a few diamonds and a beautiful background. Nature, so I made a green and a yellow kind of background. Care, so I made kind of a love kind of a splash for this one, and I really liked the color transition. And this is the music one, so this was a jazzy one. And I think that was it for this entire painting flip through with me. I hope you guys really like the painting, and if you did, then make sure to comment down below which one you like the most, and I'll be seeing you like in one of my next videos.